reading from the Nectar of Devotion.
所以每周六我们都会朗读 奉爱的甘露。
Do you have the Chinese version?
这儿有没有那个能打开维达布克的那个 找一下奉爱的甘露。
We're reading from chapter number 9.
是第九章。
Further considerations of devotional principles.
奉爱原则的进一步的考虑。
Chapter number 9. The subtitle is Archana.
副标题是 Archana, 崇拜。
Archana means worship of the deity in the temple. By executing this process, one confirms himself to be not the body, but spirit soul. In the 10th canto, 81st chapter, verse 19 of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is told how Sudama, an intimate friend of Krishna's, while going to the house of a Brahmana, murmured to himself, "Simply by worshipping Krishna, one can easily achieve all the results of heavenly opulence. All the opulences of this material world and the mystic power of performing the yoga system." The events leading to Sudama's murmuring this statement are as follows. Sri Krishna had ordered his friend Sudama to go to a Brahmana's house and ask for some food. The Brahmanas were performing a great sacrifice, and Sri Krishna told Sudama to plead with them that he and Balaram were feeling hungry and needed some food. When Sudama went there, the Brahmanas refused to offer anything. But the wives of the Brahmanas, upon hearing that Sri Krishna wanted some foodstuff, immediately took many palatable dishes and went to offer them to Sri Krishna. In the Vishnu Rahasya also, it is stated, any person within the world who is engaged in the worship of Vishnu can very easily achieve Don't adjust it when I'm speaking. Any person within this world who is engaged in the worship of Vishnu can very easily achieve the ever blissful kingdom of God, known as Vaikuntha Loka.
这里有没有能给我打开伟大部第九章能打开吗
Okay, anyway, we'll speak. Okay, I will explain it to in English and she can translate. So, Rupa Goswami is describing the different items of Bhakti Yoga.
Rupa Goswami 描述了奉爱瑜伽的不同的项目.
Right, there are mainly 9 different items in Bhakti Yoga.
奉爱瑜伽当中有九个项目.
And one of them is Archana, means worship of the deity in the temple.
其中一个是阿彻呢,是在庙宇当中崇拜神像。
So Rupa Goswami is describing this, that by performing this kind of worship, then you have to understand that you're not the body, but you're a spirit soul.
Rupa Goswami 要是说要做崇拜, 神像，首先你要明白，你不是这个躯体，而是灵魂。
And this is explained. Then Rupa Goswami gives evidence of this from the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam.
Rupa Goswami 从圣典国家瓦坛第十篇当中例举了一个例子来证明这一点。
And he tells about one of Sudha Krishna's cowherd boyfriends named Sudama.
他讲述了 Krishna 的一个牧牛童朋友 Sudama.
So one day he had gone to beg from the brahmanas.
有一天他们去向婆罗门祈求食物。
It was early in the morning. Krishna and Balaram had taken any food.
这是一大早 ，Krishna 和巴拉拉玛还没有吃早饭。
But then they saw that the brahmanas nearby had been preparing a very big sacrifice, a Vedic sacrifice.
他们看到在附近有一些婆罗门正在准备一个盛大的祭祀，准备各种各样的物品。
So the cowherd boys.Led by Sudama, all went to see the brahmanas to ask them to give some food.
以 Sudama 为首的牧牛童们就来到婆罗门跟前去祈求食物。
And told the brahmanas that Krishna and Balaram was nearby, and all the cowherd boys were with them, and they were all hungry, and they wanted some food. The brahmanas just ignored them.
当他们来到婆罗门跟前，告诉他们。在附近的 Krishna 和 Balarama 带领着一些牧牛童，他们饥肠辘辘，想要吃些食物，恳请这些婆罗门给他们布施些食物时，婆罗门对他们的祈求，置之不理。
They didn't say anything. They didn't say no, but they just didn't. They just pretended they never heard anything.
这些婆罗门也没有拒绝，并没有说不。他们只是假装什么也没有听到。
So then the cowherd boys came back and told Krishna and Balaram what happened.
这些牧牛童朋友就回到 Krishna 和 Balarama 面前，告诉他们发生的事情。
So Krishna told the cowherd boys, "Don't be disappointed." He told them, "This is the nature of begging."
他们Krishna 和 Balarama 就跟牧牛童朋友们说，不要为此灰心丧气，这就是。乞讨食物的这个本性就会这样。
But then Krishna told them, "Go and ask the wives of the brahmanas to give some food."
然后 Krishna 就告诉牧牛童朋友去找婆罗门的妻子们去乞讨。
So when Sudama and the other cowherd boys went to see the brahmanas' wives, they told them how Krishna and Balaram were nearby and they were hungry. Then immediately.The brahmana's wives got food and came running to bring it to Krishna and Balaram.
当牧牛童朋友去婆罗门的妻子面前，告诉他们 Krishna 和 Balarama 想要向他们乞讨食物时，这些婆罗门的妻子立刻跑回家拿了很多食物回来。
So these wives of the brahmanas are called the yajna patnis.
婆罗门的这些妻子们，她们叫 Yajna Patni。
Yajna means the sacrifice, and Patni means the wives. The wives of the brahmanas who were doing the sacrifice.
Yajna 就是名字 ，Yajna 就是祭祀 ，Patni 就是妻子。Yajna Patni 意思就是那些举行祭祀的婆罗门的妻子们。
So they were so eager to bring the food to Krishna.
他们特别渴望着给 Krishna 他们拿到食物。
Because they'd heard about Krishna before, they'd heard about Krishna in the marketplace.
因为他们以前在市场上耳闻过 Krishna.
In the marketplace, there were many different vendors, and they would all talk about Krishna and Balaram and about their wonderful pastimes and about their beauty and about all of their qualities.
在集市上有很多小商贩，这些小商贩他们就会彼此之间。谈论有关 Krishna 和 Balarama 神奇的事迹。
So because they've been hearing about Krishna from all of these other people in the market, they had become very eager to meet with Krishna and Balarama to see him.
因为这些婆罗门的妻子们听到商贩们讨论 Krishna 和 Balarama 的事迹，他们就 非常的渴望来见到他们。
And they came to offer everything to Krishna and Balarama.
所以他们就前来把一切就献给了 Krishna 和 Balarama.
So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes how Krishna's friend Sudama, that he was going to the house of the Brahmana, and he was speaking to himself.
然后在《释迦牟尼佛》的第十篇当中，就是谈到苏达玛，他就自言自语，他来到这个门，来到门前自言自语。
He was saying to himself that simply by worshipping Krishna, we can get all the results of heavenly opulence.
他自言自语道，一个人仅仅凭借着崇拜 Krishna 就可以获得所有的全部的富裕。
We can get liberation by worshipping Krishna.
通过崇拜 Krishna 我们可以获得解脱。
And we can get supremacy over all the planetary systems of the universe.
可以获得宇宙之中所有星系的统治权。
All of the opulences of the material world can be given by worshipping Krishna.
通过崇拜 Krishna 可以获得物质世界的所有的富裕。
And all the mystic power by, that you can get from the yoga system.Can also get by worshipping Krishna.
崇拜 Krishna 也可以得到通过八部瑜伽所获得的所有玄秘力量。
And so this is Rupa Goswami describes the power of worshipping Krishna.
Rupa Goswami 就描述了崇拜 Krishna 所拥有的力量。
So the wives of the Brahmanas, they understood this.They were very eager to go to Krishna and Balarama.
婆罗门的妻子对此非常了解，所以他们很渴望去见 Krishna Balarama.
But their husbands, they were unfortunate.
但是他们的妻子，他们的丈夫，婆罗门丈夫却是不幸的人。
They didn't want to go there. They were afraid of Kamsa.
他们因为惧怕 Kamsa, 所以不敢去见 Krishna Balarama.
They were afraid that Kamsa might hear.How they had given food to Krishna and Balaram, Kamsa may give them trouble.
这些婆罗门担心，一旦康萨听到他们把食物给予 Krishna 和 Balarama, Kamsa 就会给他们找麻烦。
But they were surprised how their wives had developed so much eagerness to worship Krishna.
但是这些婆罗门非常的惊讶，他们的妻子们却对 Krishna 和 Balarama 有这样巨大的依附之情。
When the wives of the Brahmanas came there to Krishna and Balaram, they said, we just want to stay here at your lotus feet. We don't want to go back to our husbands.
然后这些婆罗门的妻子们就跟 Krishna and Balarama 说，我们只想停留在你们的莲花足下，我们再也不想回到我们的丈夫那里了。
But Krishna said, no, it's okay, we should go back.
但是 Krishna 说这样不太合适，你们还是回去吧。
Brahmanas were saying, no, our husbands, they won't accept us. We came away, we brought all the food for the sacrifice, we brought it all to you. Maybe our husbands will not take us back.
这些朋友们的妻子就说，不，我们不回去，因为我们把所有那些为祭祀准备的食物都拿来给你们了。回去以后，我们的丈夫可能不再接纳我们。
But Krishna told, no, they will take you, they will accept you, don't worry.
但这些婆罗门的，但是 Krishna 却跟他们说，你们不用担心，你们的丈夫一定会接受接纳你们，你们只管回去好了。
So when Krishna called the gopis, and Krishna also, in the night, when he's in the forest, he would play the flute, he'd call all the gopis to come.
所以当深夜 Krishna 吹响他的笛子呼唤牧牛姑娘的时候，牧牛姑娘就纷纷前来。
So,Krishna would then tease the gopis that, well, why have you come here?
然后 Krishna 就逗弄这些牧牛姑娘，跟他们说，你们为什么深更半夜跑到这里来呢？
But then he would satisfy them, they would dance the whole night together.
然后接下来呢， Krishna 仍然会满足所有牧牛姑娘，跟他们整夜通宵的共舞。
But Krishna told the Brahmana's wives to go back.
可是 Krishna 却让这些婆罗门的妻子们回家。
So, Sudama, the Krishna's friend, is describing how You can get so much benefit by worship of Krishna.
Krishna 的这些牧牛，Krishna 的朋友就在那里自言自语，说崇拜 Krishna 一个人可以获得全部的富裕。
Of course, one should not think about what benefit he will get by worshiping Krishna.
但是一个人仍然不应该想着他通过崇拜 Krishna 可以获得这些好处。
That would not be proper worship.
是他如果他这样想，就不是一个正确的崇拜。
We have to be careful. We want to worship Krishna with pure love. That's without thinking of what we will get in return.
我们应该怀着纯粹的爱崇拜 Krishna， 而不应该想着我们能从中得到怎样的好处。
But still, the scriptures tell us that if you do worship Krishna.Definitely there will be results. You will get benefit from it.
但是经典里就声明，一个人通过崇拜 Krishna 一定会得到这样的好处。
But the devotee wants to worship Krishna, but not as a business, not thinking what we will get in return.
但是崇拜 Krishna 的奉献者，他们不应该是怀着这个做生意的好处来。做生意的想法来崇拜 Krishna， 想着能从中得到什么样的利益回报。
We worship pure love is offered without any material desire.
纯粹的爱是没有任何物质欲望的崇拜。
So these devotees, like the wives of the brahmanas, they had pure love for Krishna.
像婆罗门的妻子们，他们这些纯粹的奉献者是对 Krishna 怀着纯洁的爱。
They're showing us how to worship Krishna.
他们向我们展示如何去崇拜 Krishna。
So everybody, we take part in the worship of the deity in the temple. We have temples. We worship the deity there.
所以我们也有庙宇。奉献者们在庙宇当中崇拜神像。
And there are different deities. Sometimes we worship Krishna, sometimes we are worshiping Rama. We usually encourage devotees to worship Gornitai.
在庙宇当中有 Krishna， 有主 Rama。我们通常是推荐崇拜，鼓励奉献者崇拜 Gornitai。
Gornitai worship is very simple, easy to perform. Prabhupada said you can worship Gornitai simply by doing kirtan.
崇拜 Gornitai 非常简单易行，是的，Prabhupada 说我们仅仅通过 kirtan 就可以来崇拜 Gornitai.
Other kinds of worship require more rituals, more regulation, more serious practice.
对其他的崇拜，对其他神像的崇拜是有更多的仪式，有更多的规范原则。
We often find people have deity, they start to worship the deity for some time, and then after some time, then they stop.
我们发现有这种现象。奉献者们，他们有的开始崇拜神像，是过一段时间就停止了。
And the deities are abandoned. The deities sometimes are left.
有时候呢，这些神像就会被忽视，无人照顾。
So Srila Prabhupada was concerned that once the worship is begun, then the worship should be continued.
是的，帕帕的非常。关注这一点，他希望一旦开始崇拜神像，就要持续不断的进行下去。
We see in some temples in Vrindavan that they have many sets of deities, not just one deity, but two, three, four deities all at one temple.
我们发现在 Vrindavan 有的神庙都不止一对神像，有好几对神像摆在神堂上。
Sometimes because they began the worship, but in the course of time, the worship was not possible to be continued. So the deity was placed in another temple with another deity.
有这些神像，有的神像，他们被人开始崇拜，过一段时间呢， 过一段时间就无人再继续崇拜他们了，所以就把他们转移到其他的神庙内，跟其他的神像一起崇拜。
We know the temple in near to Mayapur. There's a temple of Jagannath at a place Rajapur.
在马普有一个神庙 Rajapur， 那里崇拜 Jagannath。
There the deity was worshipped for some years, for some time it was worshipped nicely, but then gradually the worship became the standard was reduced.
一开始呢，这个 Jagannath 的 Swaja 的神像呢。被精心的很好的照顾和崇拜，但是过了一段时间，他们的标准越来越低。
In the beginning, they would worship the deity every day.
一开始呢，是每一天都得到崇拜。
Then gradually, they started we will worship them once a week.
然后来呢，就一周得到一次崇拜。
Then it became once a month.
接下来一个月崇拜一次。
Then it became once a year.
接着是一年崇拜一次。
Just like we were in Nepal and there were some temples there, they told me they only open the temple one day a year.
Maya 说他们去尼泊尔去朝圣的时候呢，有一个庙宇，然后这个庙宇的人们就告诉 Maya 说他们一年当中只有一天才开放神庙。
But then some they will forget.To open it when it's only once a year, they forget to do that.
因为一年他们只开一天，然后慢慢的他们也许就忘记了，到这一天就忘记来开放这个神庙了。
And then when they forget to worship the deity, then they bring disaster upon the local people.
一旦这个神像被忽视之后呢，当地的人他们就会有种种的灾难。
There may be some famine or some disease, and everyone may die.
有饥荒，有疾病，瘟疫蔓延，然后当地的人就都会死去。
And then the temple, the deity falls, and nobody's there to do any worship, and the temple is not opened anymore, and becomes overgrown. It becomes the old trees grow over it, and everything is lost.
然后之后呢，因为这个地方荒无人烟，整个这个庙宇呢，它就慢慢的就是被这个杂草丛生，所有这些荆棘啊，还有这个树木都掩盖了这个神庙了。
Just like we saw the temples there in Cambodia, how some of the temples were overgrown by trees.
就像我们在柬埔寨看到，有的神庙，在柬埔寨，有的庙宇就是树庙，那里的树木就很密集。
Anything valuable that was in the temple was taken by people. There was nothing left in the temple. Even the deities often taken away.
那么这个庙宇当中所有值钱的财物都被人们给拿走了，甚至连神像本身也被人拿走了。
And then.The temple just becomes overgrown with wood, becomes like a part of the jungle.
然后这个庙宇呢，它四周就会有很多树木，最后这个神庙本身也就变成丛林的一部分了。
So very difficult, very therefore with great caution we begin the worship of the deity.
所以我们要崇拜神像，一定要非常谨慎。
Prabhupada was concerned that we keep our enthusiasm for the worship of the deity.
舍勒帕说我们崇拜神像一定要怀着热情。
We open a temple, Prabhupada said, once a temple or once a center is open, it should not be closed.
舍勒帕训示门徒一旦这个庙宇开设之后就永远不能关闭。
So, as time goes on,Then it becomes a challenge.
那么随着时间的推移，这条信誓就变成一个挑战。
Just like in the past, the worship of the deity was always done by brahmanas.
就像在以前过往的年代，庙宇当中呢，只有婆罗门才有资格崇拜。
So there are many old temples where the worship would be done one generation after another by these brahmanas.
在有的古老的庙宇，就是一代又一代的，都是婆罗门沿袭的所有这些崇拜。
Just like we go to one temple in Navadvip Dham, it's in Bilpakur.
就像在纳瓦队古道圣地有一个地方叫Bilpakur.
Bilpakur.
Bilpakur.
And the deity there is Madan Gopal.
那里的神像是Madan Gopal.
And it is said this deity is from the family of the mother of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachimata.
据说这神像是来自马哈帕布的母亲Sachimata.
Sachimata's father was called Nilambar Chakravarti.
Sachimata的父亲叫Nilambar Chakravarti.
And he was worshipping the deity, it was in his family for generations.
那么Sachimata她的神像就是她们家的，她父亲的这个神像就是一代又一代世袭下来的。
I know deities to worship today by the same descendants of that family.
这个神像至今仍然由这个家族的后代来崇拜的。
But often what happens is that the descendants don't want to just worship the deity in the temple.
但是有很多情况，这个后代他们不想崇拜庙宇的神像。
They become materialistic, and they want to get more money than a Brahmin can earn.
他们最后就越来越物质化，他们想赚钱，但是婆罗门他们不能赚很多的钱。
Instead of living in the village and worshipping the deity, they want to go to a big city and work in the company.
他们不想留在村庄崇拜神像，他们想去大城市去赚钱。
They think to just stay in the village and worship the deity, they will not have a good future.
他们认为就留在村庄里崇拜神像。 没有未来，没有什么前途。
But if they go to the big city and get a job, they can be an engineer or a computer programmer, and they can make a lot of money.
但是如果他们去大城市受教育，然后他们就可以成为一个工程师，或者是程序编程员，能挣大笔的钱。
And in this way, they can go to hell.
那么这样，他们逐渐就能去地狱了。
They're thinking this is a good life.
他们以为去大城市成为工程师和编程员是一个很好的生活。
But to stay and worship the deity, oh no, that's not good.
可是留在乡村去崇拜神像，他们认为这个不是一个好的生意。
So this is the problem today, and this has been the problem for many generations, that the brahmanas become greedy for material economic
development.
Just to be a simple brahmana, ring the bell in the temples, is not very good future.
他们觉得就是留在这个简朴的乡村啊，在那个简朴的神庙里每天摇铃，没有什么前途。
Let my son be an engineer.
他们的想法是让个儿子去当工程师。
Let him go study. Let my son do something useful with his life, like earning money in the material world.
他们的想法就是，让我的儿子去物质世界过一个比较有用的生活，去赚钱。
The And so in this way, many temples gradually closed because nobody wanted to take up the worship.
就是因为没有人想继续崇拜神像，所以逐渐的这个庙宇就一所一所的逐渐的全部关闭了。
And we have found in places like Bangladesh and Nepal and also India that there are many temples like that.
我们发现在孟加拉、尼泊尔、印度很多的庙宇都是类似的情况。
So some of the places they have donated the property to ISKCON.
所以在有的地方，当地的人就干脆把这些庙宇捐给了 ISKCON。
Often the temple is so broken down in need of repair. They don't have any money. They don't want to spend any money to repair the temple, so they give the temple to ISKCON.
所以呢，有的庙宇呢，他们已经破烂不堪了，就是需要得到修缮，所以他们就把这样的庙宇就捐给了 ISKCON。
And some places they won't give the temple to ISKCON, but they will say just give us some money.
那在有的庙宇呢，他们不愿意把庙宇给予 ISKCON, 他们就管 ISKCON 要钱。
Give us some money, we can repair the temple ourselves. You just give us some money.
他们就是管 ISKCON 要钱，就是说给我们钱，我们会自己拿花这钱来修庙、建庙。
So Prabhupada has sympathy towards these different temples, especially in the holy places, and he set up an arrangement so that we would help them to maintain and to develop their temples.
施特帕帕帕德他对这种情况就深感怜悯，所以呢，在我们 ISKCON 就有一个机构，就负责修缮所有这些破败的庙宇。
Yeah, you can go in Mayapur or around Navadvip, or you can go in Vrindavan, around the holy places in Vrindavan, the forests of Vrindavan, and you'll see some of the different temples where we have helped them to renovate the temple and to maintain the temple.
当我们去拿瓦对布、马阿婆或者本达文的时候，我们在朝圣的过程当中会遇到有一些庙宇，就是由我们 ISKCON 出资来修缮的。
And the Brahmanas also who are there, that they become very enlightened and encouraged when they see us come there with pilgrims from all different parts of the world.
而且这些庙宇的婆罗门看到当来自世界各地的 ISKCON 的奉献者。
Some of these temples are in very remote areas, and there are not many pilgrims, not many people coming.
像有一些庙宇呢，他们处在偏远的地方，而且呢，就是不能得到很多的资金或者是布施，所以他们有一些困难。
And unless one's very pure, then one can easily be disturbed by material desire.
除非一个人是非常纯粹的，否则很容易受到物质欲望的打扰。
So worship of the deity is very good, but it has to be done along with the chanting of the holy name.
崇拜神像非常好，但是一定要伴随着唱诵圣名的程序。
Sometimes people think I do my puja, and they don't do any japa.
有时候人们想啊，我会做 puja 崇拜。但是他们不做 japa.
And if they don't do any japa, then they won't have the strength to maintain the puja.
一旦他们不开始 japa, 他们就没有继续 puja 崇拜的力量。
And to keep doing japa every day, you have to understand the importance of the chanting of the holy name.
为了每天能够 japa 念诵圣名，一定要明白唱诵圣名的重要性。
You have to be hearing.Also, the scriptures to remind you of the importance of the chanting of the holy name.
还要聆听经典，能让我们记住唱诵圣名的重要性。
If you just simply ring the bell in the temple, just simply ring the bells and chant some mantras, and you don't know anything about what you're doing, you don't understand the significance, then has no meaning, very less meaning.
如果他只是一个人，只是知道如何在庙宇当中摇铃，并不知道他自己在做着什么，那 证他所做的事情是没有意义的。
So it's important that not only worship the deity, but also chant the holy name and hear from the scriptures.
所以非常重要的一点是，不仅仅要崇拜神像里的神庙里的神像，还要唱诵主的圣名，同时聆听经典。
And for that, we need also association with devotees.
为了做到这几点，我们还需要与奉献者联谊。
Okay, any questions about this? Anybody has any questions?
有没有问题？
Vaishnavi?
Sometimes when we ask people to chant the Hare Krishna mantra, they are asking that we already chant this verse from Srimad Bhagavatam.Or Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. I am so much attracted to this mantra. So, will they also progress by that mantra? They sometimes ask, why only Hare Krishna mantra like that, Maharaj?
那么这个玛拉吉的问题就是说，当我们有时候告诉人们唱诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra 的时候，这些人就说，有的人会说，我知道我会唱圣典国家瓦坛的一些。师姐，我也会唱诵 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya。我为什么要偏要唱诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra 呢
？Well, we can chant any name of God, as Lord Chaitanya says in the Shikshastikam. The Lord has many names, so we can chant some other names of God if we prefer to chant other names of God.
那么我们可以唱诵神的任何名字，就像主持人那样在。Shikshastakam 所说的，那么主有无数的名字。如果我们偏好，神的任何一个名字，我们可以唱诵神的这些名字。
We know Narada Muni instructed Dhruva Maharaj to chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, and Dhruva Maharaj was able to see God.
Narada Muni 训示 Dhruva Maharaj 唱诵 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Dhruva Maharaj 最后就因着唱诵这首曼陀罗见到了神本人。
Within a period of only 6 months, Dhruva Maharaj was able to see God.
仅仅六个月，朱瓦马哈拉就接见到了神。
But he did great austerities also.
但是朱瓦马哈拉也做了巨大的苦行。
We cannot try to imitate Dhruva Maharaj.
不能要不不人一个人不应该试图模仿朱瓦马哈拉朱瓦大君。
So some people also like to chant Vishnu Sahasranam.But we know in the Vishnu Sahasranam, at the end of the Vishnu Sahasranam, it says these 1,000 names is equal to one name of Rama.
有的人特别喜欢唱诵 Vishnu 的一千个名字，但是在 Vishnu Sahasranam 里的最后的一个十节中说 ，Vishnu 的一千个名字相当于主 Rama 的一遍的名字。
So all the names don't have the same potency. Even the name of Rama, 3 names of Rama is equal to one's chanting the name of Krishna.
并不是主的神的所有名字拥有同等的力量，即便是 Rama 的三遍的名字，也仅仅相当于 Krishna 的一遍的名字。
So according to how the name you chant, you get the benefit of.Accordingly, you can also chant other names of God, but we follow Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he taught the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra.
我们是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的追随者，而 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 教导我们唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。
We accept Lord Chaitanya as being the avatar of Krishna in the Kali Yuga.And he has come to teach everyone to chant the holy name of God.
我们接受 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是神在 Kali 年代的化身。Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在 Kali 年代降临，教导人们唱诵神的圣名。
So we follow Lord Chaitanya. And if you don't want to chant Hare Krishna, then you know, who you got? You have to follow. You have to follow somebody.Who are you going to follow? Just like if you follow Ramanuja, So Ramanujacharya, they are chanting Om Namo Narayanaya.
And
there's another sampradaya, which is Vaishnava, but not Gaudiya Vaishnava. It's the followers of Vallabha Acharya, and they chant Sri Krishna Sharanam Mama.
那么有些不是勾点传系的，他们是瓦拉巴传系的，他们唱诵的是
Sri Krishna Sharanam Mama.
Sri Krishna Sharanam Mama.
So they're chanting Krishna's name. They're chanting, I surrender, I take shelter of Lord Krishna.
所以他们唱诵的是Krishna名字。
So they're following some, they're not following Lord Chaitanya, some other
line.
But they can also go back to Godhead.
他们也可以回归神手。
But chanting Hare Krishna, we have nice tunes, nice melodies, you know, it's very easy for us to chant.
但唱诵 Hare Krishna, 我们有各种各样优美的调子, 也是很容易唱的。
刚才说一旦他们不加法，他们就没有继续铺展的力量。铺展的力量是什么意思？
Just now mentioned they do not have the strength to do puja. So what's the meaning of the strength of doing puja?
Well, to do it regularly, you have to be. First of all, you have to do it every day. You do it, you keep the standards of cleanliness and punctuality.
那么首先要每一天都做崇拜，要保持清洁，还有准时。
These are the two most important qualities in worshipping deity.
崇拜神像最重要的两个品质就是清洁和准时。
So to keep up that kind of standard over a long period of time is not easy. You have to be very determined. You understand what it means to be determined with strength to do puja? Once you begin it, you keep doing it for the rest of your life. Okay.
Some people like to chant, to sing, but they don't like to chant. So how to answer?
Well, let them do more kirtan.
那就让他们做更多，那让他们唱呗，喜欢唱就让他们更多的唱。那他平时他就不念，他不念诵，念。
No, they're not chanting, but let them do kirtan. Let them do more kirtan, and gradually, if they're really serious and they're really enjoying kirtan, gradually they'll start to chant.
如果他们更多的唱诵的话，他们就非常享受唱诵，他们有更多的品味，最后他们就愿意扎法了。Kirtan
is the beginning. You begin with kirtan, and gradually we get people more familiar to chant one beat. So it takes some time.
这是要花时间，就是刚开始他们都是从 kirtan 开始的。
So you begin with kirtan and gradually introduce them to the beat. Some people may take more time.
有些人比别人花时间要长。
But if they're really doing kirtan regularly, it means every day, then gradually they will start to chant naturally, because you're doing kirtan all the time. You'll remember, you'll be saying Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. You'll start to chant more. Even after the kirtan, the holy name will be with them, will be on their tongue. They'll keep chanting.
就是因为他们每天都开始 kirtan 的话，他们就养成习惯了，就是习以为常了。慢慢的，这个 kirtan 就变成 japa 了，自然而然的，就是圣名都跟他们一直在一起。
请问顾德，这些区别是过往业报所致的吗？
啊，the question that when the mother go to the unit to do the job, she will sing simultaneously Hare Krishna, and some colleagues will feel very glad, but some will feel very uneasy with the kirtan. So is that due to their past karma?
Yes, they may be they're because they're more materialistic. They don't like to hear the holy name.
是的，因为他们有的同事更加物质化，所以就不喜欢圣名。
The more materialistic people, they become angry, they become disturbed by hearing the chanting.
一个人越物质化，他听到圣名就会越愤怒，就越内心感到不安。Some
people have the more materialistic conditioning, they're more covered over, and they become disturbed simply by the chanting.
一个人越物质化，他的覆盖就越重，那么一听到圣名，他们就开始有不安的反应。So
you can try, I don't know, you have to be careful. Somebody becomes disturbed, they may give you some problems because you're chanting.
所以这边唐大姐。 你在单位应该小心，那也许呢，这些感到内心不安的人，他们会给你带来麻烦。They
obviously have some idea about your chanting, that you're chanting something different from what they usually hear. The sound vibration is different, and it's having a disturbing effect on them.
因为你的那个唱诵圣名的音阵，就对他们使他们有一些不安的影响，给他们带来的不安的效果。
But at the same, you see some people like the chanting, so that's good. That means they're more inclined, they're more appreciative of the holy name, they're closer to being a devotee.
你也说有的同事听到以后就感觉很高兴。
这是非常好的，就说明他们对这个唱诵圣名有更多的倾向，也许他们未来能够成为奉献者。沙姐还有个问题，那什么？Hare Krishna， 顶拜部队有奉献者分享对唱诵圣名的10项冒犯，还说还有11项阻碍他人成为奉献者。 12项把已经成为奉献者的人推出奉献者的团队。 请问姑姐，这两项是出于经典的吗？ 感谢翻译。
Some people say that except the 10 offenses, there is the 11 offenses that to prevent somebody from becoming. Prevent others to become devotee. The 12 is to kick out devotee from the group of devotees. To push them away.
I don't know where you got this from. I've never heard there's an 11th and a 12th offense.
我不知道你是从哪儿得到的。 我从来没听说过有第十这个两项，第十一项变十二项冒犯。
Of course, we do say after chanting the 10 offenses, we do say it's also offensive to be inattentive while chanting.
但是我们确实有第十一项冒犯，就是念诵时不专心，也是一项冒犯。Because
inattentive chanting is the seed of all offenses.
因为不专注的念诵会导致冒犯的种子，导致其他冒犯。What
did she say was 11?
The 11 is to prevent somebody to become devotees.
What is this? I've never heard anything about this.
Mara said he hasn't heard it.
We said the first offense is to blaspheme the devotees.
那么我们说的是第一条冒犯是冒犯亵渎奉献者。
So somebody is becoming a devotee. If we try to restrict them from becoming a devotee. Yes, they're in the first offense.
是如果有的人已经成了奉献者，然后我们把他踢出了奉献者的团队，那么这个是属于第一条冒犯之列。
And you talk about the 12th offense being rejecting someone from a devotee, kick them out from being a devotee. That's also at the first offense.
那您刚才所，萨提玛姐姐，您所说的。 这个第十一条、第十二条，阻碍人成为奉献者，以及把一个人、一个奉献者踢出奉献者团队，都是属于冒犯圣名十项的第一条冒犯之列。So
dealing carefully with devotees very important.
所以非常重要的就是很好的要谨慎的与奉献者们交往。
As normally we say in Kali Yuga, the chanting of the holy name, the
chanting of the holy name is the process. But Prabhupada also wanted, the acharyas also want us to do the arjana process. It's to bring us to mode of goodness, to regulate us so that we don't, what is the significance?
What's the question?
Normally, we
the acharyas recommend arjana for regulate our life.
What's the purpose of
arjana? 那么刚才Prabhu的问题就是，我们知道在Kali年代的程序就唱诵圣名，但是 acharya 们他们也推荐 arjana， 就是在庙宇当中崇拜神像，但是这个 arjana 他们的目的是什么？
Well, worship of the deity is one of the five items of devotional service.
崇拜神像是五项强有力的奉爱服务当中的一条。
And it said anyone who becomes attracted or attached to one of these five processes, it can get perfection.
那么据说呢，任何一个人如果他们依附这五条当中的任何一条，都能够达到完美。So
one of the five is worshiping the deity.
其中
But we said also to worship the deity, you have to also chant the holy name.
但是我们刚才说，崇拜神像，一个人也必须要唱诵圣名。And
the deity also wants to hear the holy name. The deity also likes to hear the scriptures.
而且神像喜欢聆听圣名，神像喜欢聆听经典。
He
deity is not only just there to eat.
神像他们在那里不仅仅是为了吃。
Some people, they have the deity, they just have the deity, they offer everything to the deity.
有的奉献者他们崇拜神像只是每天给他们吃东西。
That's very good.
这也很好。
But they also like to hear the holy name and hear the scripture.
但是神像也喜欢聆听圣灵，聆听经典。
You have a deity, whatever you eat in the home has to be offered to the deity.
一旦有神像，无论吃什么都应该首先供奉。
And then becomes prasada. Then you can eat prasada.
然后这些食物变成 prasada, 然后你们就可以吃 prasada。
You keep a deity, you should also think the deity is the proprietor of the home.
神像它也是这个家里的业主。
We simply live in the home to serve the deity.
我们住在那个房间里是为了服务神像。
So, deity worship is, but it's one of the nine items, one of the nine limbs of Bhakti Yoga.
神像崇拜是Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽的九个项目当中其中之一。
But when there must, as we said, it can't take, we won't chant the holy name or just worship the deity. You cannot do that.
但是我们刚才说过，你不能这样想，我只是崇拜神像，我也不念诵，不能这样去做。
Must continue to chant the holy name.
必须同时要唱诵圣名。
The holy name is a process for perfection in this age, and it's done along with other things like deity worship, studying scripture.
唱诵圣名是这个卡里年代获得完美的程序，但是唱诵圣名也应该伴随着崇拜神像，聆听经典。
Keeps us busy in the service of Krishna.
会让我们在对 Krishna 的奉爱服务当中忙不停的。
Okay, so we'll have arti.
就讲到这里，接下来我们会做 arti 灯仪。
Yeah, you follow his day, huh? Okay. Can I go ahead?